on the below on state affairs for local and international politics, security, extensive economic analysis, interviews, and world power play.
Nigerians must choose the path they want to follow. Follow the same looters and sponsors of violence who control the political structures, or encourage the formation of a new leadership team.
Be a global citizen and join the radio revolution on state affairs. State Affairs with Edmond Obilo. Radio just got deeper.
Daganan kilo kilo bedeni gom no more.
No.
Di beta maso sanalom.
No.
Muasa benge kaputo.
Yeah.
State Affairs with Edmond Obilo.
It's a story about her, a story about strength, a story about courage. It's her mission, it's her duty, it's her dream, and it's her work. She walks for days and nights to the place of the wise one. Hello. The program is State Affairs on Splash 105.5 FM, the Integrity Station. I am Edmond Obilo. Good morning and welcome.
Nigerians, why are you crying? We are crying because our leaders have failed us woefully. Let me tell you, if it is in a civilized country, by now, President Buhari will resign. Quote me anywhere and let the whole world hear it. By now, with what is happening, President Muhammadu Buhari should honorably resign. We are crying because we don't have a shepherd. All those that will fight what I'm saying now will eventually suffer the rot. If you can't do it, either you resign or you'll be changed. A good coach cannot watch his team defeated when he has players sitting down watching at the bench. Either Buhari resigned by himself or he will be impeached. This statement is too mysterious and supernatural. I know that many people begin to fight it. And back then, did you not pray for Buhari? Did someone not anoint Saul? What are you talking about? Am I the creator of Buhari? God created him. Nigerians trusted him because he did well sometime. But now, how can people be dying? The chief security officer, custodian of lives of the country, will be sitting down not making any comment. Gunmen attacking everybody anyway. What is the matter? Nigerians are crying. Why? Because there is no security in this country. House of Reps and Representatives should impeach the president if he doesn't want to resign. Number two, if the members of these two houses do not want to impeach him and they want to begin to fight for the Mbaka, something worse than what they never imagined will happen to the members of the House of Senate and members of the House of Reps. Disaster is coming.
Father Mbaka again. Father Mbaka speaks, and Buhari replies, saying that Mbaka is a contractor. Because he did not give him contract, Mbaka is angry. Hello. Abubakar Bello is the governor of Niger State.
The situation is critical and is terrible. Last night, we had over 3,000 people here from communities that have been displaced by bandits and Boko Haram elements around Munya and Shiro local governments. However, some of them have started going back to their various homes, and there are some other communities that we think are safe, they can go back. But the vast majority of them will have to remain here because their towns have been taken over by bandits and Boko Haram elements. Their wives have been seized from them. Their wives have been forcefully attached to Boko Haram members' elements. In fact, I just had reasons for a very coordinated military action to take place so that we displace. The Boko Haram elements are trying to use these areas as their home, just like they did in Sambisa. Well, Sambisa is hundreds of kilometers away from Abuja, but Kaure is less than 2 hours drive to Abuja, so nobody is safe anymore. Not even Abuja is safe. So this is the time to act. But everybody, all hands must be on deck. All hands must be on deck. It's not for Niger State alone, no. It's for everybody to act. We have made all the efforts we need to do, and we have done it. We have tried our best. I am confirming that we have Boko Haram elements in Niger State around Kaure. They've taken over the territory. They've installed their flag. I'm confirming that now. They've taken over the wives of people by force.
Do not be afraid. Do not despise your ability to make things work. Rejoice. Rejoice, for good days will come. They are the days I see. The land I see and the land I want to talk about is a land of hard-working people. People sweating all day. Their farms are dry from drought. They long for rain as they suffer in hunger. The situation scares the king out of his wits. The elders can no longer motivate their sons. Yet I say rejoice. Mothers have lost the joy of motherhood as they watch their children broken from hardship. As the people of the land gnash their teeth in agony, a maiden of the land asked the stars why they cannot call the clouds to open its rivers for her people to drink. Hey, she stands in her father's compound, reaching for the stars. Can you see her? She closes her eyes, dreaming of how she would dance with the stars and bring light to her people. Can you see her? She possesses powerful imagination. By her dreams, she shows powerful leadership. Her vision is clear and concise. Can you see her? I'm telling you a story. A story about the road to the moon. It's your story. Are you a young person? Listen to me. Nigeria is in search of leadership. Are you the one? She is the one. She is challenged by the condition of her people, and she is compelled to make a difference through the force of her own dreams, her ideas, and personality. She dreams of herself in the stars twinkling on her people. That is what she sees. But she's dreaming. She must wake up to touch the stars. I'm talking to you. This night, she wakes her parents and tells them she's going to the distant land to see the wise one. Why? She's gone to sort the route to the stars. It's her mission. It's her duty. It's her dream. And it's her work. Look at her. She walks for days and nights to the place of the wise one. On getting there, the wise one had joined his ancestors, but he left a big book of wisdom on his chair. By choosing the journey, this maiden refuses to accept the condition of the land. She sees new possibilities. She has become an agent of change. When everyone accepts to grieve over the situation, she chooses to be a leading light. To her, it's a season of redemption. That means she's breaking away from the tyranny of custom, the tyranny of tradition and conventionality that make her people helpless. It's about following the light within to illuminate society. Remember, it's her work, it's her mission. She calls, "Wise one, are you there? Where is the wise one?" When no one answers, she sees the big book on the wise man's chair. It's a book of wisdom. In the book, she finds the map showing the road to the moon, not the stars. Why the moon? Hey, why the moon? You want to say hello to the radio station and tell me why the moon? Not the stars? 080-915-51055. 080-569-98678. And 070-694-93000. Hello.
Hello. Good morning, Edmund.
Reverend Kwe Ladele is here.
Yeah, I'm Reverend Kwe Ladele. I've not changed my name yet, and I still walk around the world in Ibadan. A happy weekend to you over there.
Thank you.
I listened to Reverend Father Mbaka and the response of the government is a pity. One thing Mbaka said in his cry, he said there are a lot of people lying there, capable people who will have been of great help and benefit to President Buhari, but they are kept on the bench. He used a term, he said, will a coach watch his team losing? Is it pity? In Benin, they say it is your friend that tells you your mouth is smelling. Reverend Father Mbaka is a friend of President Buhari, like many of us, like Reverend Koye Ladele. And if today we are telling President Buhari that his mouth is smelling, that his administration is not being properly managed, that the administration he watches over is to the detriment of the people that volunteer, that sacrifice to vote for him, in the face of all odds, is a shame if they see us as contractor. If the shame is they see Mbaka as a contractor. What contract does the federal government want to give to Reverend Father Mbaka? What appointment does President Buhari want to give to Reverend Koye Ladele? A lot of good people in this country, whenever they raise their voice against government, they are labeled in one terms or the other. It is a shame on them. However, Nigeria belongs to all of us. We will not stop talking. We will not stop wailing. We will not stop crying. We will not stop telling the president the needful, whether they like to hear it or not. If you look back today, a lot of people who killed behind President Buhari, they have left his side. And that is enough for him to look back. That why are people changing allegiance? They are changing allegiance because this is not the Nigeria of their dream. They are changing allegiance because they deserve something better than this. They voted the general so that they can have security, but it is worse even in his time. They voted the man they so much believed in, like Mbaka said, he did well sometime. If there is any reason why we voted Buhari, it was on the glory of the 83, when he brought to question the corrupt people in this society. But today, they are celebrating together, and he doesn't even know what to do. If you ask me very sincerely, just like somebody asked Tunde Bakare not too long ago, is this the Buhari that you know that you gave everything for? My sincere answer is, I doubt if the president is still senile to handle affairs of governance. And I join my voice to Reverend Father Mbaka, the president should step aside. I am not asking him to resign. Let him take the back seat and allow Professor Oshibajo to move the nation forward. Good morning.
Thank you, Reverend Koye Ladele. I'm talking about the girl on the road to the moon. She finds the map showing the road to the moon, not the stars. Why the moon? What has Mbaka said? There is a diamond in the moon, sitting on the book of discovery, where the stories of men are written. For rain to come, she will read the book and protect the diamond, for it is the heart of the land. Reading the book is to be wise. She must get herself to the moon, and the stars will be closer. What did she do? She pulls out the map from the Book of Wisdom and set out for the junction where seven roads meet. While looking at the map to know the road to follow, a heavy wind blew the paper from her hand. It is the work of her genius to find the road that takes her to the river bank, from where she will cross to the other side of the world. She is in search of light so that her people will be happy again. She relies on her judgment in pursuing her course bravely. I tell you, she will attain immortality. It's her leadership. Who wants to say hello to the radio station? Have you seen the front page of the Vanguard? Mbaka is a contractor presidency. APC threatens to report him to Pope. Go ahead, APC, report him. Why we need mercenaries, lawmakers speak. Federal government outraged. Issues shoot at sight order. Declares prisons red zones. Again, armed herders kill five in Benue. Politicians behind arrest in Southeast. Dr. Ogoji's message to Ndibu. May Day, Labour asks federal government to reclaim Nigeria from insurgents, bandits, and kidnappers. NMPC makes U-turn. Says FARC remittance will be boosted. Despite headwinds, Zenith Bank's profit after tax rises by 5% in the first quarter of 2021. How we can stop banditry? Casino SSG. Banditry here, banditry there. Is the story of her journey to the moon. She will rely on her judgment in pursuing her course. She will attain immortality. It's about you. In attaining immortality, she finds crocodiles in the river, and there are no canoes to cross. She's not in a hurry. She builds a tent at the bank. She will study the character of the river to know when to move in. She must be patient. To be patient is to grow in strength and wisdom. Watch out for her. She's coming. She had read in the Book of Wisdom that the crocodiles take a deep sleep when the stars are out. That's the time to cross. Watch out for her. She's coming. She's here. On this night of stars, she enters the river to cross. She has a chalk with her. She will write her story on the wall of the other side of the world. Water must not wet the chalk. She must avoid the deep side of the river and find the log of the big iroko tree the storm buried in the river. It's her word, it's her time to shine. If she looks well, she'll find the log in the dark water and she will walk on it. By reading between the lines of the Book of Wisdom, her heart leads her to the log. It's about you, it's about your mind, it's about what you are thinking, it's about if you are listening to the story of time, how the beautiful one is here. I can see her in the river. She's trying to cross. She walks carefully, afraid the crocodiles will wake up. While in the middle of the river, the sky becomes overcast. It is a sign of a heavy rain, and the stars locked their doors. With the stars out, the crocodiles are awake, and they see a stranger in their water. She has come into the waters of the crocodile. We shall break through. We shall find the road to the moon when we shall bring the stars. It's your story. It's your time. It's your happiness. It's your mind. She's in the water. The crocodiles are awake. But from the Book of Wisdom, she knows that to be strong and powerful is to rightly control and direct the thoughts and impulses within you. It's about the strength to resist fear. Take note of that. Now she will exert her genius to survive the crocodiles in the water. As the crocodiles get closer, she sees their bulging eyes and their ugly teeth. In this moment of courage, she renders the song of peace, the song of peace her grandmother taught her. She sings well. Can you hear her singing? Her voice is captivating. The rhythm is enduring. It's a lullaby for hungry crocodiles. As she sings, the moon hears her voice as the stars come out to sing along. A new day has come. The stars are out again and crocodiles fall asleep. Her song is a lullaby for a restless land. What has she shown? She has shown that in moment of danger, she can be a maiden of light. That's why James Allen says that it is in the epoch of threatening disaster, ruin and persecution which divides the sheep from the goats and reveals to the reverential gaze of succeeding ages the men and women of power. She has crossed to the other side. She is in the moon, flipping through the book of discovery. She's on her way home. The diamond is wrapped in the Ankara her mother gave her to cover herself when cold comes. The book is in the bag made of lion skin her father gave her. As she approaches the land of her people, it starts drizzling. Can you see it? A new dawn has come. I have waited for this day. It is here. As I speak, it's been raining in the land and their farms are green again. Their hearts are gladdened as joy unspeakable comes. To make a land great, one must be imbued with the love, purity, and compassion of the mind. What can you take away from my story? She's a study in true leadership. It's her time. In her journey, she shows positive, constructive, dynamic, and effective leadership. She's not Buhari. She's a star. She has shown that progress depends on leadership. No, she's not Tinubu. She has vision of what she wants to achieve and backs it with the values of courage, patience, brilliance, and humility. She can't be Jonathan. She motivates herself with her dreams and commands the stars. She's the beautiful one. She has not accepted the status quo by saying that's how we were born. She knows what was important and how to go about it. She knows the way and shows the way. She is the leader. She is focused. She doesn't give up hope. She's a visionary. She's not Uzodinma. She sees the stars, not the obstacles. She doesn't concern herself with cynics, discouragers, and doubters. She's not afraid to fail. Those who dream live. Hello. Recognize your potentials and walk towards a great dream, for it's time to shine. It's my story, it's your story. The lines are open. 080-915-51055. That's the number to call. 080-569-98678 or 070-694-93000. Talk to the radio man. Hello. Good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Yes. Okay.
It's good to hear from you this morning. And it's good to hear Reverend Kuri Ladele, which is an ardent supporter of the president, lamenting of his failure. We as Nigerians, we've already given up on this administration. But your point this morning is intriguing. I hope you can open up the poem enough for us to understand more and more. I've been with you listening to the poem since the beginning of your program, and it's wonderful. And I hope this country gets its roof back by 2023, hopefully. God bless you, sir.
All right, thank you. The background noise, but anyway, he made his point. The lines are open. The stars are here. I can feel the stars. I have waited for this day. The day is here.
Hello, good morning. Edmund the Great.
Good morning.
This is Adigie Olajunka, calling from Oyo.
Thank you.
Nice to hear from you this morning. May the Lord bless you and God will be with you.
Thank you.
We love your narration this morning. And we shall, I will say that we are all witness Nigeria of our dream in the mighty name of Jesus. See people, we are following you. Thank you very much.
Thank you for calling the radio station. Say hello to the radio man. The radio man is here. I'm your friend. Hello.
Good morning, Bill.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
I want to give you one assignment first before I pass my comment. The 1940 Abadir agreement, please, can we get it? Let us look at all the clauses involved. Where are these agreements? We need to see, that is the base of Nigeria. And so we need to see, we can't be building on nothing. If we don't follow that agreement, it stipulates that after 100 years, there should be a referendum to decide whether we are going to stay together. It's a divorce in marriage. People cannot be forced to stay together.
Are
the problem
sure?
We have is that once
you've not seen the document. Have you seen
I've not seen the document, but that's what I was told. That's why I say I'm giving that effort to get that document. Why that Google is to get it? That the British will have it in their museum. Yeah.
I'm not sure it's written in that document.
Okay, that's why we say let us get it. And we can see that talk.
I have it. You it's everywhere. Okay. Google it. Download it.
All right. Okay. If it's not there, then let us sit down. You don't force a mind to an association.
It's like in marriage, you can divorce. Even in life, there's an alternative. That's why people commit suicide. When you think it is better for you to die than to stay alive. So all this talk they are talking about war. Who is talking about war? Let us sit down and settle Nigerian question. We want to go back to each region. That was what our founding father agreed in 1955-57 when they went to Lancaster in London. Not this situation that the ministry imposed upon us. We know what is happening. The governor says, the president says, Utama has to abide with the president's decision that they should do Ruga. That means they want to force Fulani on Midube to take over their land. It is Fulani in the Midube, it is Fulani in the southwest, Fulani in the southeast, Fulani in the south. Why are they the only one? We have over 300 tribes in this country. Why aren't they the Fulani, for God's sake? Because the president is supporting them. That's why the king will not anything. He told us that attack against Boko Haram is attack against the North. I didn't do anything about it, nothing. Nigeria voted for it because we thought it would stop our security progress. As a former leader, we have failed us here. Economy has failed. Complete failure. Let him resign or be impeached. That's not that is the constitution. It's the constitutional provision. He can be impeached. Right. Let them impeach. Right. Okay, good morning. Thank we are tired of these battles. Every morning people we hear people dying.
Thank you. Reverend Ejike Mbaka is here.
Nigerians, why are you crying? We are crying because our leaders have failed us woefully. Let me tell you, if it is in a civilized country, by now, President Buhari will resign. Quote me anywhere and let the whole world hear it. By now, with what is happening, President Muhammadu Buhari should honorably resign. We are crying because we don't have a shepherd. All those that will fight what I'm saying now will eventually suffer the rot. If you can't do it, either you resign or you'll be changed. A good coach cannot watch his team defeated when he has players sitting down watching at the bench. Either Buhari resigned by himself or he will be impeached. This statement is too mysterious and supernatural. I know that many people begin to fight it. Mbaka, did you not pray for Buhari? Did someone not anoint Saul? What are you talking about? Am I the creator of Buhari? God created him. Nigerians trusted him because he did well sometime. But now, how can people be dying? The chief security officer, custodian of lives of the country, will be sitting down not making any comment. Gunmen attacking everybody anyway. What is the matter? Nigerians are crying. Why? Because there is no security in this country. House of Reps and representatives should impeach the president if he doesn't want to resign. Number two, if the members of these two houses do not want to impeach him and they want to begin to fight for Mbaka, something worse than what they never imagined will happen to the members of the House of Senate and members of the House of Reps. Disaster is coming.
State Affairs with Edmond Obilo is live.
Splash FM 105.5.
Guy, you don't see that new funny video for Twitter? That one with the boy. You mean this one? What of that brother Shaggy new skit? Where they circulate WhatsApp?
Oh, this one.
What of that meme? Where the guy?
Where mouth open like this, ba?
Mr. Noito, which data you dey use know all these things?
Now, glow new data plans get me.
Are you serious?
With just 50 naira, I dey get 50 MB. And with just 100 naira, I dey get 150 MB. Where I fit use chat or browse on top Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, and even Snapchat. Don't dull yourself. Dial *777# now. Make you begin the browse the go.
Glow Unlimited.
orí rédíò tí àjọ search for common ground ṣe àgbékalẹ̀ rẹ̀ pẹ̀lú ìrànwọ́ owó láti ọwọ́ àjọ European Union.
Bí ẹ kò bá ra àwọn ohun èlò oúnjẹ yẹn, máa kó àwọn ọmọ mi, màá sì padà sílùú ńlá.
Kí ni àwa ṣẹlẹ̀ síṣẹ́ onídìrí rẹ?
Olùkọ́ àgbà, ọkùnrin yìí ni ó jí agolo gàrí kan lọ́dọ̀ Yelisa.
Kí wọ́n ní ìdí tí ẹ ṣe fẹ́ sun láàyè nítorí agolo gàrí kan àbí?
Eré aládùn orí rédíò yìí àwarawa yóò máa wá sí ti ìgbọ̀ yín.
Ní gbogbo ọjọ́ Ìṣẹ́gun, Tuesday,
láago mẹ́jọ alẹ́.
Lórí ìkànnì yìí, Splash 105.5 FM.
Ẹ kú ojú lọ́nà.
Àwarawa, 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 là ń tọ́jú ara wa.
Catch your favorite shows live on Facebook. You can watch your favorite presenters and listen to your favorite programs on our Facebook page every day. Go to Splash FM 105.5 on Facebook, like our page, and get updates when your favorite program is streaming.
Mọ̀nàmọ́ná a máa fúnni ní ìmọ́lẹ̀ a sì máa mú ìdẹ̀rùn wá láti wá dènà ìjàmbá iná mọ̀nàmọ́ná. Ojúlówó wáyà tàbí kébù ló yẹ ká fi fa iná nínú ilé, lọ́fíìsì àti nínú ìlú. PureChem Wires and Cables ni àwọn iléeṣẹ́ mọ̀nàmọ́ná àti àwọn agbaṣẹ́ṣe yàn láàyò. Ojúlówó ni kì í bó lára, kò kí ń jóná àbàjì, kì í kán sínú, ó sì fini lọ́kàn balẹ̀. Ìdí nìyí tí Standard Organization of Nigeria fi fòǹtẹ̀ tẹ́ tí Nigeria Electrical Contractors náà fi dìbò fún. Bí copper cable ṣe wà ni aluminium cable ń bẹ nípele nípele lówó tí kò gunpá. PureChem Wires and Cables tó jẹ́ ọ̀kan lára àwọn ọmọ ẹgbẹ́ Kaman ló ṣe ojúlówó wires and cable jáde. Olú iléeṣẹ́ PureChem Wires and Cables Limited wà ní Afrin's Compound, Fort Gate, number 122/132, Osodi Apapa Expressway, Ijana Isolo Bus Stop, Lagos. Ẹ̀rọ ìbánisọ̀rọ̀ wọn ni 08080303257. PureChem Wires and Cables. Ìrọ̀rùn fi iná mọ̀nàmọ́ná.
Splash FM, we believe that the business of broadcasting in today's society should not only be about information dissemination, but ultimately about the quality of those who do the job. Our next agenda is to restore and consolidate the integrity of broadcasting, to train, to equip, and to mentor the next generation in the art and science of broadcasting, leveraging over a decade of excellence in the industry. Anticipate.
Splash FM 105.5.
State Affairs with Edmondo Bilo is live.
Unknown gunmen attacked the country home of the governor of Imo State, Hope Uzodinma, in Omuma, in the Oru East local government area of the state. In the Saturday morning attack, the governor's house is set alight as two security operatives guarding the property are killed. Things fall apart. Hope Uzodinma is the governor of Imo State.
Let me use this auspicious occasion to reiterate my stance that the recent security breaches in the Southeast do not in any way or manner suggest that Ndigbo are tired of being part of Nigeria. All we want as a people is a united Nigeria where justice, equity, and fair play will be the driving criteria for our mutual existence. We need a big Nigerian family. Secession is not on the table. Anyone championing secession does not at any way or level represent the interests of Ndigbo. We have a greater stake in a united Nigeria and will not be party to any scheme that will bring division among us. All we want is equity, I repeat, justice, and a level playing ground that allows the eagle to perch and also the kite to also perch as well. My takeaway package for 14 members is this. Unemployment is at the root of criminality in Nigeria and indeed Africa. This is followed by ethnic distrust, which is often fueled by insensitive public statements by some members of the political class, who most times places self and primordial considerations above national interests. Find the cure to these two cancers, and Nigeria and Africa will remain relatively safe and secure.
State Affairs with Edmond Obilo is live.
You know, insecurity is taking new dimensions. The governor's house being attacked. Autumn was attacked. What do you see? On the front page of the Saturday Punch, police continue VIP duties as bandit terrorists kill over 269 in April. Is it possible that VIP will be denied of police escort? Is that possible in this present Nigeria? The police is meant to protect the leadership class. That is how the Nigerian system is designed. So why do we continually say what is not true? Every new IGP comes out to say, oh, we'll take policemen from VIPs. Say that to the moon. The moon is listening. Good morning, Radio Man. That's coming from Oladele Do Joseph on State Affairs page on Facebook. Oladele Do Joseph says, things we always fall apart in a place where there is no justice, equity, and fairness. He asked, did we listen when Orubebe was trying to warn us of the impending doom in 2015? We simply laughed and called him a madman from the Niger Delta. Now it's dawned on us, the giant ship of our country is lost to wild wind on the ocean, and the guiding compass is nowhere to be found. Idowu Joseph says the captain of the giant ship is power drunk and obviously unconscious. John Paul Azuka says, Edmund, the country is boiling. People are being killed every day. The media doesn't report all. Traveling is now a mirage. Fear everywhere. The country is falling apart. Hopefully, we overcome. Musbaudin Abdusalam is on State Affairs page on Facebook. He says, thank Allah, she didn't lose everything. Peradventure, she would get some leads and guides from the Book of Wisdom. Abdusalam talks about my poetic story. He comes to the Taliban. He says it seems Taliban has become something else. He's now responding to another session, a section of my post. He goes, no developed country that didn't steal technology and idea from others to get where they are. Sadly, African nations still allow their country as dumping ground. You know, globalization. How has Africa responded to globalization? The lines are open. Let's talk. Banter with the Radio Man. It's your time to shine. Leave a message for the Radio Man on his social media pages. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes.
Good afternoon.
Can you turn down the volume of your radio, sir?
Hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, sir. You're pleased to be
right, please turn down the volume of the radio set. It helps communication. Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
My name is Mr. Fadiyan, calling from Woro.
Turn down the volume of your radio set, sir. I can hear you. Thank you. Hello. All right, thank you for calling the radio station. Sorry about that. Just keep trying. Bullet in the neck. You'll find that on my page, State Affairs on Facebook.
Hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
My name is Ben Bede. I'm calling from Lekki Kisswan.
All right.
Question. Concerning this amalgamation of 1914, people that participated in signing the document, because because UNWK was born on 1904, so who are the people that participated in signing the amalgamation documentary of 1914?
You see, it was a conquered territory. They didn't need your permission to sign any agreement. They conquered the territory. The colonialists came in with their guns and conquered the territory. Take note. And they decided what happened. I hope we get that clear. Thank you. You know, I hear who signed the document. Where do you sign a document when you have been conquered? They conquered the northern part of the country. They moved from the into the hinterland. They had guns. They conquered Benin. They sacked Obaovorame. It was a war. And they dictated what happened. They chose what they wanted. They gave it the name they wanted. It wasn't about you. But now, it's about you. Redefine it. I don't bother myself about a 1914 document. I only read and study it. In my time, we'll build a new document. Okay? But we'll also learn from the past. Hello, good morning.
Hello?
Hello, good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Edmond. My name is Mr. Fadiyan, calling from the world. Thank you very much for you have been encouraging us about this nation. And I hope one of these days things will be okay. And we pray it will be during our own lifetime. And Mr. Edmond, let me first of all take you on one of your guests that came about 3-4 weeks ago. You invited that man. You said he was former DCP or something like that. I tried to call him that day, but I wasn't through. He was trying to tell us Nigeria is not right for state police. That thing has been in my mind that any time I called him, I have to take on the man. I think anybody that loves this nation now should stand up and be clamoring for state police. My brother, Edmond, maybe I don't know, maybe the area you came from the east. I cannot, as an Ibadan man, go to your state and mind your state because I don't know the place. Why will somebody from Maiduguri come to Lagelu where I stay here in the bush and say you manage for me? No. So anybody that is not supporting state police is looking for the problem in this nation. And I am trying to put my own voice now that we should have state police. And finally, Mr. Edmond, I am very surprised about these our so-called men of God. Because as a Christian, many of them, before General Buhari came, they said emphatically and said, "God save the Lord." Lord told us that Buhari is going to turn around Nigeria. Is the Lord not speaking again? Good morning, Mr. Edmond. Thank you.
You know, sometimes because they are men of God, we think they are not human. You know, I see, somebody says I'm a man of God. So that person is beyond flaws. That's the point you make when you define men of God as if they have no dent. that whatever they say is perfect. It's not true. Mbaka made it clear that it's human. They are human. And when you say vision, you know, in recent time I've been studying, how do you become spiritually powerful? What is vision? How does it come? How do you see it? How do you interpret the happenings around you spiritually? My research tells me it also depends on the biases of the mind. You know, vision is a reflection of the mind. It's when you attune your mind to certain atmosphere that you begin to experience vision. But those visions are also tied to your experiences. That is why Pastor A sees this, Pastor C sees that. That is why Native Doctor A sees this, Native Doctor B sees that. So I don't assume Adeboye is infallible. No, I don't make such assumptions because he is fallible. Edmond Obilo is fallible. It is not the assuming of perfection. It is attaining a level of perfection good for the growth of society. So preacher men are also analysts. You know, analysts base their breakdown on certain facts available at certain times. Mbaka has seen Buhari, so he has new data to make his conclusion, and he has made his point. Can somebody say hello to Father Mbaka? Hey, are you there? Call the radio station. Good morning.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Boy. I'm calling from Mododo.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I want to disagree a bit with you on your last submission. Mm. You see, if these men, so-called men of God, tell us that if their prediction, their prophecy, based on their own personal findings, now it would have been a different case. But they are telling us God said this, God said this, God said that. You know, and the God that I know, that I serve, that I believe doesn't, is not a contradictory God. God doesn't contradict things. You know, when God speaks, he speaks the way it should be. And that's one. Then two, my concern about Nigeria is that I doubt if things will change. The reason is that, you know, the political class control the electorate. They have the electorate in their pocket. So at the end of the day, they determine who the electorate votes for. You know, ordinarily, you know, the normal people, most of the people that contact on radio, talk on radio, this and that, you hardly see them go out to vote on election day. And I think that is why I doubt if things will change in this country. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, this question of God, have you asked yourself, if perfection is the ultimate aim of God, why did God create Lucifer if you are a Christian? And at the end of the day, he was also disappointed by Lucifer. Jesus is Lord. Why did he not prevent Judas Iscariot from going? You know, certain things are placed to make humanity understand itself. That one I'm not speaking on behalf of the pastors, but I'm telling you my research and experiment on becoming spiritually powerful shows me how powerful you are spiritually is the content of your mind and the ability for you to exist within certain sphere of knowledge. In that knowledge sphere, you then begin to make your own interpretations of the things you see. That is what is called vision. So stop assuming it is perfection. That is why I am an inquirer. I don't just accept it because Adeboye said it. No, that's not me. I query them, make my own analysis, and come up with my own logics. Because I have the power, that power in me, that spiritual power, to make my own interpretations. But again, the interpretations you make, remember, are dependent on the power of your mind. Let me tell you about the program you are listening to. You are listening to State Affairs on Splash 105.5 FM, the Integrity Station. This program brings to attention socio-political challenges and suggests ideas for their resolutions. Produced in documentary, feature, and news formats, State Affairs follows the historical approach by dealing with chronological accounts of events and tracing the role of individuals and institutions in global, African, and Nigerian affairs. State Affairs is for the purpose of informing and educating the public. My program, your program, State Affairs, also adopts philosophical and behavioral approaches to attain its objectives. So when you see me wax poetic, when you see me sound folkloric, I'm trying to wax philosophical. I also study what you say to make certain conclusions. At the end of this broadcast, I go back to listen to the phone conversations to be able to read into the behavior of the people. That is why I say the program is behavioral. It helps me define the next line of thought. So, what am I saying? State Affairs is a qualitative experiment on media as power and development. State Affairs is politics in the 21st century. I hope you are enjoying it. What are the objectives of State Affairs? What is the radio man driving at with the program? One is to influence beliefs, attitudes, values, and behaviors. That is why the program is anchored on discovery, the power of knowledge. State Affairs is a program to raise an informed populace conversant with the issues that touch upon their lives. That is why radio has just gone deeper. State Affairs is to enhance the democratic process. And if you listen to State Affairs, it helps to bring active audience participation in public deliberation and social change. My program is to help change the world and the people in it. The program is to create a platform central to the governing process by complementing the legislature, judiciary, and executive. And let me announce, State Affairs is to maintain high standards of excellence in journalism. The judgment is yours. I appreciate you for being there. Many years. Booze Oi. Economic Searchlight. Legislative Matters. The Sport Horse on Sport Bank. Just Football with the Sport Horse. Village Square with the Sun in the Sky. Thank you for being there. You are my friend. Watch out for the radio, man. I hope you will be there when I knock. Enlist, for a new dawn will come. In our time, my time, your time. Say hello to the radio, man. Talk to me. Hello.
Good morning, Mr. Edmond.
Good morning.
What I just talk about is
All right, this line is not clear. Thank you for calling the radio station 080915 08068. Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Mon. Today's piece is beautiful and is teaching us a terrible lesson. That child that you have just told us about is a 2-year-old Nigerian sitting on the gun of on the keg of gunpowder, holding a mastic. One has to be extra careful taking the mastic from him. I pray Nigeria will not be set ablaze. Good morning. God bless you. Joseph Olutunji Ogunrikpe, challenge.
Thank you. After World War One, President Woodrow Wilson of the United States, in January 1918, while presenting his 14-point agenda, argued in favor of self-determination of nationalities when he proceeded, "An evidence principle runs through all the program I've outlined. It is the principle of justice to all peoples and nationalities and their right to live on equal terms of liberty and safety with one another, whether they be strong or weak." Professor Tony Falola is my friend. In this intellectual talk, I explore his idea of self-determination. But first, he has to listen to me. From literatures, advocates of self-determination point to the conflicts that exist in a state of nations as the reason they seek for one state, one nation. Let's go to Europe. Balkan from time to time revolted against the leadership of the Turks. Czechs and Slovaks revolted against their domination in Austria-Hungary, like Biafra revolted in Nigeria. However, there is no historical or sociological justification that a mononational state like Somalia offers more stability than a polynational state like Nigeria. If you look at the question of India at its formation, you know, Pakistan made the argument of religion. The majority of Indians are Hindus. So Pakistan decided to break away on the ground of not wanting to be dominated by the Hindus. But before we knew it, Pakistan broke up, and it was just a monolithic country in terms of religion. Bangladesh needed to break out of Pakistan. Professor Fayola, please address this for me. Does it mean that what makes a group of people a nation is not necessarily a community of race, language, or religion, but the sentiment of common consciousness or like-mindedness?
I will first of all complicate your question for you, because that's what I do as a professor, and then I will answer it. So you can divide societies into various forms. The multi-plural, as in the case of Nigeria or the United States. The mono that you've spoke about, as in the case of Pakistan that you invoked and Somalia, and the dual, D-U-A-L, that people don't talk about, the case of Rwanda, with different management styles. The most difficult to manage is actually the dual societies. And so far, we do not have a major scholar that has given us the theory of managing a dual society. And the current president, who has been staying for power for so long and who is not intending to leave, criticisms for and against may ultimately lead us to that kind of theory, which is, how do you manage a society where you have two groups, the Hutu and the Tutsi? Whom do you vote for? Will a Tutsi vote for Hutu? So that one is there. Mono society fragments, refragments in itself, just as Igbo did, just as Yoruba did in the 19th century, into other form of cleavages. So, for instance, in federal Nigeria, the Yoruba present themselves as one group. But in the 19th century, they fought one another for over 100 years. Don't forget, they fought one another for 100 years. They are producing the city where I was born, Ibadan, as a war camp, and generating the 16-year war fight. Remember this history of Ilorin. So even if you are mono, what you do is you create other forms of cleavages. And those other forms of cleavages acquire other forms of identities. So let's say you have Islam, you can be Sunni, you can be Shiite. Other forms of cleavages will emerge. So that doesn't tell us you won't fight. Then you now come to plural societies. In those plural societies, you have internal boundary structures and notions of citizenship. Some countries are lucky. Like in the case of a plural society like the US, bear in mind that the boundaries of states are not coterminous with the boundaries of ethnicities. People tend to forget that when they invoke the US example. It is not just one group living in the state of Texas. It is not just one group living in the state of California. If you put all black people in the state of California, and you put all Texas, all Hispanic in the state of Texas, and all white people in the state of New York, they will fight. They will also fight. But those cleavages are differently structured, and they're structured not along ethnicity as you have in Africa, but a long race. And bear in mind, the Indian example you invoked, many people tend to forget the approximation of Hindu ideas into the Indian constitution. This is a point that people tend to forget, that when they were formulating the Indian constitution that provides stability, they work into it many ideas of Hinduism, in which it forms a template. I apologize for invoking Balewa here. If you look at the argument of Bello in the 60s and in the 50s, you could see how he disagreed with Aolowo and Zeke along the same question that you posed. And the way he formulated it is, why can't we recognize our differences? We don't have to merge our differences. We can recognize them and structure a political arrangement that will work with those differences. So that's one argument. Now, as to whether you can build sentiments and consciousness, why don't you turn the nation into a religion, which is the American model, the European model? Create what is called a civil religion. What do they mean by that? The concept of the flag, which is to unite you. The concept of a national anthem, that's a religion. The concept of a pledge. And then flesh them into policies like the Nigerian National Service, the federal government schools that you created, based on the assumption that if people intermarry, if you move products of the Obafemi Awolowo University to Zaria, they will understand people in Zaria. But that has had an opposite effect. Because the argument is that the more Igbo people in Ibadan know the Yoruba people, the more things will work. Why don't you govern on the premise of class? Why don't you invoke Marxism instead of the liberal national sentiment? That if you can accumulate all the poor people, and the Nigerian political parties have demonstrated that, because there is only one political party in Nigeria, Tiff Tiff Party, TTP. They are all thieves, you already know that. because you can move from one party on Monday to another. But the argument of the left, if the poor people can come together, right, they will form the real insurgency to formulate the framework and the plank to unite people. But the strong ethnic identities, the strong religious identities, and we have to accept that these things are strong. They're being manipulated. They're there. They also constitute serious obstacles. Having said that, let me make 2 points, one that will shock you. If you look at this topic, I do not know how many of you are aware that the African armies have killed their citizens than foreigners. The Nigerian army has killed more Nigerians than non-Nigerians. Ditto for other places. Thus negating the very purpose of the army. Because if the purpose of the army is to stabilize your politics, it's not to kill your own citizens. The Nigerian police, historically from the colonial state, is structured to protect those in power. That is its function. From the time the colonial state created it, it's not connected to ideas of citizenship, but connected to the idea of the number of police that is used for members of the Senate, House of Representatives, cabinet members, governor's wife, is far more than the number that is looking for thieves and kidnappers. But that has its origin from the colonial state. Now, let me now shock you. You know, there's the argument that maybe our problems are not enough. Maybe we have not generated enough problems. And that because we have not generated enough problems, maybe we have not generated enough solution. Where is the street fight? Where is the poor people's army? Where is the unity of millions of poor people marching on the streets? Why will you go to the senator for money? Why will you take 3,000 naira to vote for someone to become a governor? And some people will say, okay, also let's shift this conversation to the followers themselves. And let's also shift this conversation to the issue that maybe these problems have not overwhelmed people to know that they should have a stake. In the book, elegantly titled, We All Be Our Friends. Actually, I ordered that book. Well, it turns out that the intention of the author is different from the intention of the title, because he's trying to formulate in that book cross-cutting ties that will bring people together to see many of what we're talking about as a common problem that should unite our people and unite them in ways in which we will restructure the idea of citizenship, restructure the idea of followership, and begin to question leadership more aggressively and more forcefully.
State Affairs with Edmondo Bilo is live.
Speaking there with Professor Twin Falola is Jacob and Francis Sanga Masika Chair in the Humanities and University Distinguished Teaching Professor of History at University of Texas. It's still about the search for leadership. Professor Adigun Agbaje is a professor of political science. The resolution of the crisis of the Nigerian Civil War was supposed to be a motivation for a new country devoid of the forces that suffocated it. Adigun Agbaje is of the view that war destroys, but it also renews and constructs. Assessing the war, he concludes that in terms of the war state nexus, the aftermath of the Nigerian Civil War is a litany in contradictions, a set of paradoxes. He says the war changed everything but nothing, that it marked a turning point to nowhere. How do we then save the country produced by the war? We use the crisis in Benue State to make our analysis. This is a 2019 discussion with Professor Adigun Agbaje. Let's break this down. Yeah. It's from the governor of Benue State, Samuel Utum. He says, what is happening to us is not a hidden agenda, because the headsman, through Miyeti Ala Kauta, had said at several fora that they want to take over the Benue Valley. The attacks are also the continuation of the jihad, which was truncated by the Benue people in 1804. This is coming from a governor.
Yeah.
What does it portend?
Well, basically, you get what you deserve. So if we are going to be afraid of the future, then let's work to change the trajectory of the future. If Nigeria continues to go like this, there may be no future, because there is so much distrust based on what people can see. It's not a question of people, you know, conjuring up the potentials for disintegration. The potentials are already being worked upon. And that's why all the good people of Nigeria need to form a trans-ethnic coalition to begin to seriously address some of these issues. The problem with those in government is that they are so swamped with the minor things of, I want to hold on to power, I want to amass so much wealth. The strategic issues of the continuity of Nigeria in a peaceful, ethically sound manner that delivers justice to the people, it's not there. And when once you continue to do all these things, then the infrastructure for unity continues to decline, continues to disappear. And then the reality is that people use violence as an instrument of bargaining, and then it becomes established, and then everybody forms his or her own militia, and then the spaces for peace just continue to disappear. And we, like I said, this is not about foreboding. This is the reality that is working itself out.
Is this how nations fail?
That is how they begin to fail. Somalia was one country, one people. And that's why I said at times we overblow the ethnic agenda. But what we cannot overblow is the leadership question. The Somali leadership just frittered away the unity of the country. Despite the fact they were just one people. Then people found other avenues to mobilize. They went to the clan level and mobilized and got rid of the leadership without putting in place an alternative. Because again, of course, you can never tell what will be the outcome of violence. And so decades after, the Somali nation and state is still in trouble.
Professor Agbaje, I'm worried.
Yeah.
We have the Professor Agbaje's scholars who have done research on states formation, on development, yet we are poor. Yet the state remains chaotic. Yet bandits have taken over the north. Yet kidnappers have taken over our highways. Should I blame Adigun Agbaje too?
Well, I would say that we are all to blame. But, you know, in a sense, we are all to blame. But again, at the end of the day, who carries the can? Who is able to say, let's bring all those that are knowledgeable, and not just academics? I always say that increasingly a lot of the skills that we need to reconstruct Nigeria outside of the university system. I mean, people like you, public intellectuals, who are on top of the situation. So let's look in unusual places, all the unusual places. Let's mobilize our resources. Let the elite change from, you know, when you look at the story of the First Republic, or up to the First Republic, what did we see? We saw an elite, generally, that was ready to listen, that was tapping into its intellectual environment. When you talk about the free education in Western Nigeria, it was intellectuals that constructed that program and ensured that there was public resistance to the program. But it was whittled down because the program was constructed in a manner that people could see the logic and everything based on intellectual input. Our leaders were intellectuals of the highest order.
And we need to go back to that
era.
State Affairs with Edmondo Bilo is live.
Adigun Agbaje is a former Deputy Vice Chancellor of the University of Ibadan. He's a professor of political science. We had that discussion in 2019. 2021, how far, how well? I'll be back after this break. Don't go away.
State Affairs with Edmondo Bilo is live.
Splash FM 105.5.
Skylink Recruitment Services is here again with a wonderful opportunity for anyone who wants to study abroad, especially in the Caribbean country. The Caribbean country is between USA and Canada. Courses available are medicine, nursing, cybersecurity engineering, and accounting. Benefits of this opportunity are zero deposit, easy education system, affordable tuition fees. Students can also easily travel on visitation to Canada, USA, and United Kingdom. There are 2-year clinical rotation can be done anywhere in the world, and students can also work in any of these countries after graduation. We officially represent 2 universities for these programs, All Saints University and American University of St. Vincent. To get more information and register, visit us at S7-594, opposite Welldrop Filling Station, or it's a Challenge Road, Ibadan. Or contact us on 0903-566-4201. 0903-566-4201. Skylink Recruitment Services. Studying abroad, made easy.
Hello, good afternoon. How may I help you, please?
Yes, I would like to buy data to watch plenty videos. You know now, music, sports, in short, everything on YouTube.
What is your budget, sir?
As low as possible.
Well, how does 50 naira for an hour sound?
50 naira for 1 hour? Ha! Talk true!
Yes, with Glow YouTube plan, you can stream all your favorite YouTube videos for as low as 50 naira.
Hey, what do I do?
Simply dial *777# to get started.
Get the super affordable YouTube time-based plans from Glow and start feasting on your favorite YouTube videos for as low as 50 naira for 1 hour during the day and 50 naira for 5 hours at night. Dial *777#, select data, select social bundle, and select YouTube to choose the Glow YouTube plan that's just right for you.
Glow Unlimited.
Do you need a school with highly qualified and experienced teachers? A school with over 37 years experience of developing talent and achieving academic excellence. St. Catherine Schools is the school for you. We have a crèche, nursery, primary and A-level center. St. Catherine Schools is a government and Cambridge approved day and boarding co-educational school with a vision of moral and academic excellence. St. Catherine Schools is equipped with modern science, computer and home econs labs with state-of-the-art music and art studio. Entrance examination is conducted every last Saturday of the month from March till August, 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. St. Catherine Schools is located at Plot 3 and 5, Aleshinloye, GRA, Phase 2, New National Museum, Aleshinloye, Ibadan, or your state. For more inquiries, call 09 09 0909-0909-0909. Again, 0909-0909-0909. Or log on to our website, www.stcatherineschools.com. St. Catherine Schools, perfection through excellence.
At Splash FM, we believe that the business of broadcasting in today's society should not only be...
Guy, you don't see that new funny video for Twitter? That one with the boy, you mean this one? What of that brother Shaggy News Kitty, where they circulate WhatsApp?
Oh, this one.
What of that meme, where the guy?
When mouth open like this, ba?
Mr. Noito, which data you they use know all these things?
Now, glow new data plans get me.
Are you serious?
With just 50 Naira, I they get 50 MB. And with just 100 Naira, I they get 150 MB. We have to use chat or browse on top Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, and even Snapchat.
Well,
don't dull yourself. Dial *777# now. Make you begin the browse the go.
Glow Unlimited.
It's game night at the Bensons and everyone's having fun. Then, this.
Hey, son. What's the matter? You too? No way.
Don't let coughs and the common cold ruin your fun time. Texio range of uniquely formulated day and night syrups provides effective relief from cough and cold. Product may cause drowsiness. Tuxil, the job gets done when the cough is gone. If symptoms persist after 3 days, consult your doctor.
Do you need a fully furnished, nice and comfortable hostel accommodation in University of Ibadan? Or a place for seminars and executive trainings at the same venue? You do not have to worry. Adebayo Akande Hall suits your lodging needs and provides you a home away from home. Adebayo Akande Hall is a 4-star hostel built in a serene environment with constant supply of electricity. It has fully furnished rooms that gives you great comfort at an affordable price. Adebayo Akande Hall is located at Ajibode Extension, University of Ibadan. To make reservations, visit www.adebayohall.com or call the numbers 0805-699-8718, 0805-699-8719, 0805-699-8720. Adebayo Akande Hall. Built for comfort.
Built
for you.
At Splash FM, we believe that the business of broadcasting in today's society should not only be about information dissemination, but ultimately about the quality of those who do the job.
Our next agenda is to restore and consolidate the integrity of broadcasting, to train, to equip, and to mentor the next generation in the art and science of broadcasting, leveraging over a decade of excellence in the industry. Anticipate.
Splash FM 105.5.
In the global village of conflicting ideologies and complexities, understanding systems and schemes through awareness and social reconstruction becomes expedient.
They never told you how you offended them?
I'm not on trial, so I can't go before
them. Join the radio man, Edmond Obilo, on State Affairs for local and international politics, security, extensive economic analysis, interviews, and world power play.
Nigerians must choose the path they want to follow. Follow the same looters and sponsors of violence who control the political structures, or encourage the formation of a new leadership team.
Be a global citizen and join the radio revolution on State Affairs. State Affairs with Edmond Obilo. Radio just got deeper. State Affairs with Edmond Obilo is live.
John Oguche Onyisi is on Edmond Obilo's page on Facebook. He says the best government of criticism like APC should do is to right the wrongs of previous administration. Oguche does not think Nigeria is half better than Buhari and his propagandists met it. The only thing Father Mbaka did not see in his prophecy about Buhari then was that Buhari has nothing to offer other than height, exactly as King Saul possessed. You know, Father Mbaka even made mention of it. Was it not God that chose Saul in the Bible? Was it not God that also removed him? So, why are you critiquing Mbaka for choosing Buhari? You can hear people say, oh, you made us vote Buhari in 2015, so we should be crying because we voted Buhari. Hey, learn to move on. Learn to move on. Let's not cry over it. Ufoma Emmanuel Etubo says, Jonathan was weak. Jonathan was weak. Now, your strong man Buhari has destroyed the country, pushing us to anarchy and doom. Ufoma Emmanuel Etubo is saying that this government seems to be comfortable with what Nigerians are facing. Mr. President should step down now if he has any integrity left in him. Ufoma has spoken. Hello, Ufoma. This is what I think. Jonathan was weak. You know, I'm not saying that Buhari is good. But see, Nigeria has been on a free fall. If Jonathan had had another 4 years, we'll still be where we are. That's the point I want to make. You see, Nigeria, the next president, if we don't change the system, will be worse. Go and get the person from anywhere. You know, this has been coming. The political leadership has so messed the country up that the country is on a free fall. And I hear people say, oh, we must restructure. You don't have to wait for Buhari to restructure. Nigeria is restructuring itself. Are you not saying it? Oh, we need state police. Militias are emerging from all corners. Buhari cannot even stop it. The Igbo nation woke up and said, oh, Ebubeagu. You have Ebubeagu in Igbo land. You have ESN. In Yoruba land, you have Amotekun. OPC is rising. You're waiting for restructuring. It's not about whether Buhari wants to restructure. The country will restructure itself. But if we don't manage that kind of restructuring, we'll descend into anarchy. That's my fear. It has to be managed.